Superposition is one of the most popular attractions at the Quantum Fair. It almost always shows up with the same old cat story. That quantum cat everybody's heard of, that's both alive and dead at the same time, superposed in two different vital states, undefined between the two. Until, of course, we measure it and we force one of them to collapse with a totally random outcome. In this video, I won't talk about whether cats or electrons can literally be in two states at once or if they merely appear to be. We'll discuss that in a video about the interpretations of quantum mechanics that Pablo and I, just to make you suffer, are going to keep pushing into the future. Whatever this physical reality may be, what I really want to explain is how these mixed states are nowhere near as simple as you've probably been told. Typically, you'll hear that Schrödinger's cat can be alive, dead, or both alive and dead, which in itself is pretty surprising. But the even bigger surprise is knowing that if quantum cats did exist, not only could they meow in these three ways, but they could also be alive and dead in an infinite number of ways. And that infinity is far more complex than you think. For starters, having one quantum cat with a 50% probability of collapsing into a living state and another 50% chance of collapsing into dead is super basic. It isn't insane to think you could have a combination in which the two probabilities aren't equal. Take a real-life example, atomic orbitals. The electron shown in this orbital has no vital state, but we can talk about its position. The electron here is undefined, just like the quantum cat's state, only that lack of definition is in space. In one sense, we could say the electron is superposed in multiple positions, but that superposition isn't uniform. If I force the electron to define its position, I have a better chance of finding it here than here. In my starting mixture, certain states have greater value than others do. What this means is that every state the cat can be in has an associated weight, a number indicating its presence within the superposition. In fact, these weights are very closely related to the probability of the cat collapsing into one state or another. I'll use a graph to make this clearer. Let's assume we have a perfectly horizontal arrow that represents a living cat, and another perfectly vertical arrow representing a cat in a dead state. So, a living and dead quantum cat has to be represented by a diagonal arrow. This arrow can be broken down into a vertical part and a horizontal part, and the value of each part depends on the weight. A lower arrow means it has greater horizontal value, telling us that the term live kitty weighs a lot more. There's a much higher probability of the cat collapsing into alive than into dead. And the opposite is also true. The steeper the arrow's angle, the more vertical value it'll have, the greater the weight of dead kitty, and the more likely we are to find it dead when we measure it. In short, there are infinite ways to create a dead and alive quantum cat, simply by adjusting the weights. But wait, not all of them are valid. For example, if we take the weights of this state and calculate the probabilities using the Born rule, we see there's a 3,600% chance of finding the cat dead and 400% of finding it alive. That doesn't make sense. You can't have a probability greater than 100%, and you can't have arrows whose probabilities don't add up to 100%. So the only arrows that can represent quantum cats from the real world are the ones that are anchored to this curve. Here, the probabilities do add up to 100, or to put it another way, here the arrow's weights are normalized. Since we're already using fancy new words, let's add another. If you want the quantum cat to undergo a transformation that will make it change over time, you've got to make sure that transformation turns your arrow into another one inside the curve. If it moves the outside arrow, you'll get a state that would be impossible in the real world. We might say that this transformation should only rotate the arrow, not alter its size. Changes that meet this requirement are called unitary transformations, and they're really important. The fact that quantum time evolution has to respect unitarity, and that this rule is pretty much inviolable, creates certain paradoxes in physics. For example, when gravity comes into play. But back to our topic, because we've barely scratched the surface of all the ways we can create a Schrödinger's cat. The Born rule tells us that the probability of the cat collapsing into that state is the squared modulus of the weight. Keyword, modulus. The modulus is a mathematical operation that eliminates any negative signs appearing in it, which means there's no reason why the weights can't be negative. There's no chance of obtaining absurd probabilities or anything like that. This extends the curve across the space of possible states, forming a circumference. Pay attention to what's happening here. As the weights could be negative, this means we can have a living cat plus dead cat state. But there's also a state of living cat minus dead cat, and also a negative living cat minus dead cat state. And of course, all the states in between, an even more diverse infinity. Stay with me, because this is about to get even more complicated, if you can believe that. The modulus doesn't just work with positive and negative numbers. It also works with complex numbers. As we saw in the video about wave-particle duality, a complex number is basically like an arrow, although this arrow is completely separate from the one representing the state of the quantum cat. A complex number points in a certain direction, like an arrow tracing an angle, which is called the complex phase. It also has a magnitude, which would be the length of the arrow. And what do you know? It's called the modulus. To find the modulus of a complex number, you just measure the length of the arrow that represents it. And that length squared is the probability of measuring the accompanying state. So the weights that generally accompany states in the quantum world aren't mere quantities. They're complex numbers with their moduli and phases. As before, not all combinations of complex numbers are possible. Only the normalized ones can exist. Even so, this gives us infinite ways to make a Schrödinger's cat, a much richer range of possibilities than before. In fact, this very richness contains a large part of the quantum essence. This is because, just as adding positive and negative numbers cancels them out, when complex numbers with different complex phases are added, they also tend to cancel each other out, or at least offset each other to a certain extent. Otherwise, the double-slit experiment wouldn't work the way it does. If all the weights related to undefined spatial position, what we call the wave function, weren't complex, then nothing would come up quantum. The weights would be equal at every point in space, maybe amplifying a bit in the middle where they overlap, resulting in a pattern not all that different from the classic one. Complex weights, by canceling each other out in some places and reinforcing each other in other areas on the screen, are what create the bizarre pattern that drives us all wild. Quantum mechanics has that undulating sensation precisely because of complex numbers. When we learn about complex numbers in high school, they seem pretty artificial. As if they were just intellectual toys for mathematicians with no real-world applications. But the truth is that we couldn't understand the universe without them. Complex numbers are the language spoken by quantum mechanics. If any numbers deserve to be called real, it's them, as much as it may upset a few cats. But wait. We've talked about how to calculate the probabilities of finding the cat alive or dead, but what about the probability of another combination? Is that even possible? The answer is yes. In fact, our atoms do it all the time to hook up with other atoms. But that's a story for another video. And remember, if you want more science, just hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching.